Welcome to this guide on Amazon CloudWatch Network Flow Monitor. Today, we'll explore how to effectively monitor and analyze your AWS network traffic. To get started, we're going to select the flow monitors in the CloudWatch console. On the right corner, we're going to enable the Network Flow Monitor, which is going to create service linked roles in the account. It could take up to 2 minutes before you could see the Getting Started page. The first step is to install the agents on your machines. Second, we review the workload insights on the CloudWatch console. Additionally, we're going to create monitors for your workload. And four, we're going to verify the metrics for each workload and detect AWS network issues. As the agents are not installed, we don't see any workload insights yet. So to get started, we're going to go to EKS console. I already have an EKS cluster in the account, so I'm going to select my cluster, click on the add-on tab, get more add-ons. As a prerequisite, I would need a pod identity agent. I'm going to select that and add it to the cluster. So click next, and then create. So as you can see, this data is in creating state. I'm going to wait a few minutes and hit refresh. The status has to be active state before you could actually add the Network Flow Monitor add-on. Once the status is active, we're going to confirm and then get more add-ons. Now we're going to scroll and then find the Network Flow Monitor agent add-on. Scroll to the bottom and select next. Click next. Now we're going to create the add-on. We're going to wait again until the second add-on is in active state. So let's refresh after a few minutes. And now it's in active state. Once both agents are active, we're going to go back to the CloudWatch console and then select the flow monitors. As the agents are installed and running for some time, I would see some data on the workload insights. The graph represents the data transferred over time within an AZ. As I have two AZs, I would see two different graphs. You could also see the top contributors below the graph. Select different tabs to see between AZs, between VPCs, and other destinations. So let's scroll down, and then you would see other graph for retransmit timeouts and retransmissions. Now, to create a monitor, select the Monitor tab and then click on Create Monitor. Provide the monitor name and select a local resource. Local resource is where you want the data to be captured from. And remote, let's select everywhere. Click Next, review the settings, and then create a monitor. Now, let's go back to the monitor to review the metrics. As I've just created a monitor, it could take up to 15 minutes, so I'm going to come back and then refresh the page. So let's go back to monitors and then click on demo to review the metrics and the overview of the workload. As you can see, my health indicator says healthy. I have different stats to review the overview of my workload. Over time, it would tell you the data transferred, retransmit, round trip time, and other key metrics. Let's verify a few widgets to understand the key metrics of a flow monitor. Retransmissions, it tells me if my packets are dropped or deleted in the network. Over time, I do see some retransmissions. Moving forward, you see round trip time, which is measured in milliseconds. Now, let's scroll to the top and select the Historic Explorer tab. On this page, you should see previous flows and the topology automatically created. To further inspect the flow, let's look at the topology that's created. The node types are listed below, and this represents the flow of traffic. To further get more insights, you could scroll to the right on the table and review the columns. To add more columns, you could click on the settings and then check the boxes that you need. You could verify the port numbers, IP addresses, and different other parameters. Click on confirm, and you should see more columns added. As I do not have retransmission timeouts in the flows, I do not see the data in the time window. Now, let's check the CloudWatch metrics for each monitor. Select all metrics and then select Network Flow Monitor namespace. The dimension is going to be the monitor ID, and then you're going to see each metric per monitor. The health indicator metric would be represented with zeros and one. A zero represents there's no underlying AWS network issue. Now, let's see how you can create a CloudWatch alarm on these metrics. So let's pick the metric, click on Graph Metrics, click on the bell icon. We're gonna select the threshold. Anything greater than zero, you wanna get notified. Let's put zero here. Scroll down and then click Next. On the Actions page, we're gonna select SNS topic for the alarm and click Next. And you're gonna put the alarm name. So let me put demo underscore NHI underscore alert. That's gonna be the alarm name. Click Next and create. So this is how we create a CloudWatch alarm on the network flow monitor metrics. I'm gonna verify the CloudWatch alarms again. And this covers the four-phase implementation of CloudWatch network flow monitor. And thank you for watching.